Hi guys, and welcome back to my course. In this video, we will learn how to improve performance by avoiding unnecessary re-renders. If you remember the lifecycle methods, there was one called shouldComponentUpdate. We can use it to avoid unnecessary re-renders. We all know that rendering is a heavy process, especially when the layout is very complex. And every time the setState function is called, it starts the entire cycle of component update. A new virtual DOM is created, compared with the old version of virtual DOM, and then it updates the actual DOM. This can hurt the performance of a React app drastically if done wrong. So the rule is simple: avoid unnecessary re-renders as much as possible. And how do we do that? We can use the shouldComponentUpdate lifecycle method. It gives us access to next props and next state. We can compare if the values are changed or not. If the values are changed, then we can re-render, or else we can avoid it. Another thing to remember is that React is very fast. So normally you wouldn't have to worry about adding should component update to improve performance. But if you notice that your app's performance is not good, then you can use auditing tools to benchmark the performance and use shouldComponentUpdate at the right places to get the best performance. So coming back to our current product details component, even when the same item is clicked, the component gets re-rendered. So opening our console. So as you can see here, when I click on this item, it prints rendering app.js. When I click again and again and again, as you can see, it keeps printing rendering app.js. Now these are unnecessary renders. Nothing is being updated in the UI, but the update cycle is triggered. So let's try using shouldComponentUpdate to fix this problem. So come in here. So whenever this color option is clicked, this position, it updates current preview image pos, which is a state variable. So let's try adding shouldComponentUpdate lifecycle method here. So shouldComponentUpdate. And as I mentioned, it gives you access to next props and next state. So next props and next state. So if you try printing it here, say next props, sorry, let's print next state here because we are handling it on state changes. Similarly, let's also print current state. So that would be this dot state. For now, let's just return true. So coming back to our browser. So now when I click on this red one, so as you can see, we've got the next state. So in this case, current preview image position one, so which was the red one. And for current state, the current preview image position is zero. So this is the previous state before updation. So all we have to do is just put a condition if these two values are same or different. So if these values are different, that means our component should get updated. But if these values are same, that means our component should not get updated. So coming down here, let's put our condition. So if next state dot current preview image position is equal to current state dot current preview image position. So that means if both the values are same, which means the user is clicking on the same preview image. In that case, return false. Let's just comment these console statements here. So coming back. So now when I click on this red one, as you can see, rendering app.js is printed. Similarly, when I click on this blue one, it gets printed again. But now if I click on the blue one again, as you can see, it's not getting printed. So if you print here, say inside should component update, let's try again. So when I click here, as you can see, it's getting updated. But if I click on the same one again, it goes to should component update, but it returns false. And that's how it helps us improve the performance by avoiding these unnecessary re-renders. Now this was a very simple use case, but this is how shouldComponentUpdate works, and this is how you can use it to avoid these unnecessary re-rendering of your component. And that's all for today. I hope this gave you a better understanding of performance optimization using shouldComponentUpdate. But if you have any doubts or queries, feel free to drop a comment below or reach out to me on Twitter. I'll add my Twitter handle in the description below. See you in the next video. Bye and take care.